Hello, I'm Emily from Museum of the North, and welcome to Virtual Family Day Exploration. So today we're going to go on an expedition in the museum galleries and talk about some objects related to exploring Alaska. The first object is the ship's compass from the 1800s. It came from a Russian ship. People have been exploring Alaska for thousands of years. The first people arrived in Alaska about 14,000 years ago and have been exploring ever since. So tools like these were used for people to find magnetic north so they knew where they were going. And so other ways to do this included tracking the stars or the sun. And so tools like these help people navigate their environments. Right next to the compass, we have a little portable stove. Now this stove was used in the 1913 expedition that was the first to ascend the south peak of Denali. So tools like these helped people survive in new environments and reach new places. One of the people who made use this stone was Walter Harper, an Athabascan man from interior Alaska, who was one of the first people to reach the summit of Denali. Our next objects are these three pairs of snow goggles. Yupik and Inupiat people in Alaska use these snow goggles to help while they're traveling on the snow to prevent the bright snow from blinding them. They have little slits in them so you can see out but not be blinded. And these were made out of many different materials, such as wood and bone and even ivory. Tools like these help people explore their environments. The indigenous people living in Alaska have been developing inventions like these for thousands of years to help them survive and explore their environments. Here we have Blue Bay, who is a mummified steppe bison who's about 36,000 years old. Miners dug them out of the frozen permafrost in the 1970s. Paleontologists use fossils like Blue Babe to investigate the Earth's history and explore what we know about the past. From studying Blue Babe, scientists were able to tell that he was killed by an American lion, which they can tell by claw marks, and they can also tell by the condition of his body that he died in the early winter. So scientists all over the world use fossils like these to learn more about the past life and environments of our planet. So here we have a boat motor in the 1920s. This motor was used by Otto Geist in his expeditions traveling around Alaska. Scientists often travel to do field work to learn more about the history of our planet and about the plants and animals that live here. So they use many tools to travel around, including boat motors such as these. Here we have a painting by artist Fred Muckatons of a dog sled called Off to the Trap Line. So dog mushing is a very popular way to explore and travel in Alaska. People have been doing it for thousands of years. There's a long tradition of it, and they continue to do it today. That's a uniquely Alaskan way to explore the environment. Here we have a drawing by Inupiat artist George Akupuk. It's drawn on hide, and it shows many different ways to explore. We've got some boats here and here. We've got someone walking over here. We've got a dog sled, and we even have a man carrying a pair of snowshoes. So this drawing shows many different ways that people explore in Alaska. And it also shows how exploring can inspire artists to make their own artwork. I hope you've enjoyed our expedition to the Museum of the North, showing how people explore in Alaska in the past and today. So thank you for joining us and enjoy Virtual Family Day Exploration.